As you've seen in the earlier segments of this series, naturally healthy soil is much more efficient at storing and cycling nutrients. Over time, you'll be able to grow crops with far less chemical fertilizer. But the first few years can be challenging. Before we talk about ways to deal with those challenges, think back for a minute on what we know about developing healthy soil. Remember the main problem with tilling crop residue into the soil. When plant material is buried, it gives the following crop a quick boost of nutrients. Very little soil organic matter remains to store and cycle the nutrients from your chemical fertilizer. Any nutrients the plants don't use are lost for good. But now you've begun reducing soil disturbance, and you're keeping the plant residue on top of the soil. Organic matter is starting to build up in your soil, but you've got a problem.
It takes time, and those first 3 to 5 years are the most difficult for this whole process. In fact, you'll probably have to use more fertilizer, you'll probably have to use more herbicides those first 3 to 5 years.
This is because the soil organisms that are building organic matter are able to use the nutrients before your plants are. At first, you'll need to feed both the plants and the soil organisms.
The first thing that comes back is the soil structure and the infiltration. And the most difficult one to get back is the nutrient cycling. And that one takes feeding the soil system, feeding it with diversity, 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 diversity.
Remember, once you've established productive soil in the field, you'll gain about 1,000 pounds of nitrogen for every 1% of SOM. The good news is that as you build SOM, your nutrient efficiency is rising as well. More nutrients are available to your plants, and less is leaking into the environment. Depleted soil is like a leaky faucet. More organic matter in the soil, along with all the organisms that grow in the organic matter, is able to stop the nutrient leak. And along the way, you've cut down on the amount of nutrients that were flowing into ponds, streams, and groundwater. Good nutrient management begins with good information. Accurate soil test data is vital. Develop a nutrient management plan that takes into account your cropping history, which crops you expect to grow in the future, and realistic yield goals for the upcoming crops. Solid record keeping is also important when you begin your work to rebuild depleted soil. Accurate records enable you to monitor the buildup or depletion of nutrients over time and avoid being caught off guard by the nutrient demands of your crops. You may not be aware that most agencies responsible for fertilizer recommendations make those recommendations based on conventional tillage. Nitrogen recommendations don't take into account the amount of organic matter present in your soil and your surface residue history. However, your soil test laboratory will be able to analyze your soil for organic matter content. It's very important that you start tracking SOM levels as you begin a program of reduced tillage. After 5 or more years of no-till or strip-till, and with a mature residue layer, you may be able to take a nitrogen credit. A rough rule of thumb is between 30 and 50 pounds per acre. If you suspect that your soil organic matter is now able to provide a substantial amount of nitrogen for your crops, you can get an idea of your nitrate levels through the pre-side dress nitrogen test. Often the results of this test give farmers the confidence to reduce their side dress nitrogen by as much as 50 pounds per acre. Interpreting the results of a pre-side dress nitrogen test requires expertise. Talk to your NRCS agronomist or to farmers and extension agents who have experience with it before you get started. Cutting back on nitrogen fertilizer doesn't come without some risk, and you're probably reluctant to take any steps that might result in lower yields and a loss in income. And nothing says you have to back off on nitrogen everywhere at once. You can set aside part of a field to experiment with lower amounts of side dress nitrogen and then compare the yields with the rest of the crop. With time and experience, you'll develop a sense for how the changes in your farming practices are affecting the fertility of your soils.
We decided, with the help of a district conservationist who gave me a lot of help, John Timmons, that we should cut down on this fertilizer and see what it would do. We planted some test plots where we cut it down to half, a fourth, and some of them with none in it. the one that we didn't have any nitrogen on, we took a tissue sample and sent it off, and there was nothing lacking in it. So I decided if I didn't need it, why buy it?
You may be used to taking a 40-pound credit for a crop that follows soybeans. Legume cover crops typically deliver an even greater benefit that can be considered when you work out your nitrogen needs.
One of the last hurdles for me personally as a county agent making recommendations on nutrients was, can we have the confidence that that nitrogen is out there and is available for the plant during the growing season? And I guess it's somewhat of a process, but where we've gained that confidence is just actually reducing our amount of nitrogen going into the growing season that we would apply in corn. We took a really big step last year and reduced our nitrogen application by 50%. And in this particular field that I'm standing in, as far as I know, it was our highest yielding field of corn in Turner County last year. And then with cotton, cotton production of 12, 13, 1400 pounds with only 30 units of nitrogen compared to where we'd be recommending applying a commercial application of nitrogen, commercial fertilizer of that 100 to 125 pounds. We've grown some 60, 70 bushel grain sorghum with no nitrogen application. So it's there, we just gotta take that leap of faith or step out there and know that it's available.
Phosphorus, potassium, and micronutrients are typically more stable in the soil than nitrogen. For this reason, it makes more sense to use the recommendations that come back from your soil tests. But here too, you can expect healthy soil to conserve nutrients. Fields under reduced tillage, and especially fields that have been cover cropped, generally consume less chemical phosphorus, potassium, and micronutrients. For more information on nutrient management, you can consult NRCS Conservation Standard number 590 or contact your local NRCS or Extension office.